Let's rock!
A new frontier of foul.
Huh? Who's there?
Get him!
You think we could ask them to turn this down? I can carry something if you need me to.
Thank you.
lobby. going up.
Hold up there. First time in Good Neighbor? You can't go walking around without insurance.
You better back off, or you're the one who's gonna need insurance.
Well, hey, all right. We'll just say your insurance is paid up for now, okay?
Whoa, time out. Someone steps through the gate the first time, they're a guest. You lay off that extortion crap.
What do you care? She ain't one of us.
No love for your mayor, Finn. I like you already. Walk into a new place, make a show of dominance. Nice. Good neighbors of the people, for the people. No love for your mayor, Finn. I said let her go.
You soft, Hancock. You keep letting outsiders walk all over us. One day, there'll be a new mayor.
Come on, man. This is me we're talking about.
Soft, Hancock. You keep letting outsiders walk all over us. One day.
Now I know you had a hand handled back there, but a mayor's gotta make a point sometimes. You all right?
I'm fine.
Good. Now don't let this incident taint your view of our little community. Good neighbors of the people, for the people.
I feel you.
Good. You stay cool, and you'll be part of the neighborhood. So long as you remember who's in charge.
Thank you.
gather around. Let's kick the breeze back. Shoot the fat. Now, I know you all are doing your own thing, but I don't want anyone here to forget what matters. Hey, Daisy. Glad you could make it. How's my favorite girl doing? Didn't I see you on a date with Murawski the other day?
He wishes.
All right. We're getting off track. What was I saying? Oh, that's right. What matters. We freaks gotta stick together. And the best way to stick together is to keep an eye out for what drives us apart. You feel me?
Yeah, you tell it like it is, Hancock.
Now, what out there in our big, friendly Commonwealth would want to drive us apart? What kind of twisted, unneighborly boogeyman would want to hurt our peaceful community?
The Institute and their synths!
That's right. Who said that? Coming up to my office later, you've earned yourself some jet. The Institute. They're the real enemy. Not the Raiders. Not the super mutants. Not even those tools over in Diamond City.
I don't know, Hancock. I'd sure love to give McDonough a kick in the ass.
Hey, we all know I got my own personal beef with that lardhead. But stay focused. Now, I want everyone to keep the Institute in mind. When someone starts acting funny, when people are doing things they don't normally do, when family starts pushing you away for no reason, we all know who's behind that kind of shit. And the only way to stop it...
Brotherhood of Steel better stay out of the way. You know what I'm saying?
What? Where'd she go?
Now, I want everyone to keep the Institute in mind. When someone starts acting funny.
Well, well, Mr. Valentine, I thought you had forgotten about little old me.
May have walked out of the den, Irma, but I'd never walk out on you.
Amari's downstairs, you big flirt.
Dr. Amari?
Yes. I take it this isn't a social call.
Doctor, it's time for you to reverse death itself.
What?
I wouldn't have put it quite that way, but it's true.
Right.
Are you too mad? Putting aside the fact that you're asking me to defile a corpse, you don't realize that the memory simulators require intact, living brains to function.
Technically, the corpse was defiled already.
This dead brain had inside knowledge of the Institute, Amari. The biggest scientific secret of the Commonwealth. You need this, and so do we.
Fine. I'll take a look. But no guarantees. Do you have it with you?
Did you say that like Dr. Frankenstein?
Igor, fetch me the brain!
Sorry.
No, I will not. Now, do you have it?
Here's what I could find.
What's this? This isn't a brain. This is... Wait, that's the hippocampus. And this thing attached to it? A neural interface?
Those circuits look awfully familiar.
I'm not surprised. From what I've seen, all Institute technology has a similar architecture.
So, the brain is still good, right?
Possibly. There's no sign of decay, so the tech is probably preserving the tissue, injecting some kind of compound to keep it stable. But there's no way to access the memories inside without a compatible port.
You're talking about me, right? I'm an old synth.
There could be long-term side effects.
Don't bother. I don't need to hear them. Plug me in, Doc.
Hey, I appreciate this, Nick.
You can thank me when we've found your son.
Whenever you're ready, Mr. Valentine. Just sit down.
If I start cackling like an old grizzled mercenary, pull me out, okay?
Let's see here. I need you to keep talking to me, Mr. Valentine. Any slight change in your cognitive functions could be dire. Are you feeling any different?
There's a lot of flashes. Static. I can't make sense of any of it, Doc.
That's what I was afraid of. The mnemonic impressions are encoded. It appears the Institute has one last failsafe. There's a lock on the memories in the implant.
Tell me you have a way past this, Doctor.
Let me think. The encryption is too strong for a single mind. We load both you and Mr. Valentine into the memory loungers. He'll act as a host, while your consciousness drives through whatever memories we can find.
Nick and I are gonna share a mind? I'm not gonna see him in any compromising positions, am I?
Yeah, if a smart mouth was all it took to solve problems, we would have found your son by now.
No. You won't have to worry about that.
All right. Let's get started.
Just sit down over there, and keep your fingers crossed.
See you on the other side.
What were you hiding? This thing's got stims in it.
initiating brainwave migration between the transplant and the host. Mnemonic activity coming from the transplant. It's degenerated, but it's there. We're going to load you into the strongest memories we can find. They might not be stable. Just hold on. Can you hear me? Ah, good. The simulation appears to be working, although the memories are quite fragmentary. I'll try to step you through the intact memories and hope we find one that gives us some clue to the Institute's location. There. This is the earliest intact memory I can find. Remember, you are experiencing these memories.
I was such a dummy back then.
This may prove.
What did I know about how the world worked? Mom knew how it was. She wasn't soft, but she loved me in her way. And Dad was either drunk or not around. I guess he must have run with one of the Raider gangs, but I never really knew what he did. Don't know why Mom was with him. Maybe at some point in his life he wasn't a complete asshole.
All five states have now signed on, which means that as of this moment, we are all citizens of the new California Republic. I'm sure that's gonna take some getting used to for a lot of people.
This doesn't seem to be what we're looking for. There appears to be another intact memory close to you in temporal sequence. There.
The thing about happiness is, you only know you had it when it's gone. I mean, you may think to yourself that you're happy, but you don't really believe it. Focus on the petty bullshit or next job or whatever. It's only looking back, by comparison with what comes after, that you really understand that's what happiness felt like. I was the worst thing that ever happened to her. If she'd never met me, she'd have stayed in the hub, maybe hooked up with someone who didn't kill people for a living. Probably been happier than she was with me. Almost certainly lived longer. Whatever made me think that a guy like me should have a daughter? No, I never deserved her. Not for one second.
It's gonna be...
Let's keep looking. I'll connect you to the next intact memory.
How did you think this was gonna end, Kellogg? You thought you could just fuck with us, and we wouldn't fuck with you? Just so you know, they died like dogs. And you weren't there to help them.
I found another memory to try. I'll connect you.
There's always someone who wanted someone else dead. Sometimes just roughed up, but dead was usually what they wanted. Sometimes they thought they could. There was always a job for someone like me. Didn't matter what it was. I don't remember much from that time. It all kind of blends together. It was almost always a bar, though. I didn't care where I was going. Ended up mostly wandering east. Getting as far away from San Francisco as I could, maybe.
Mind if we sit down?
Suit yourself.
So, I hear you'll take care of people's problems. Is that right?
If you pay me.
Oh, we'll pay you. And, you'll do this all by yourself?
That's right.
We pay you when the job's done. Is that okay?
That's the way you want to do it. So who do you want dead?
Well, it's like this. There's his family. Lives down the creek a ways.
Well, we seem to be getting closer. Try this next one.
Mr. Kellogg, I'm glad you decided to meet with me.
So, you're with the I finally ended up in the Commonwealth. I kinda ran out of road. Plus, I'd come to terms with life. I wasn't gonna be stupid enough to get mixed up with caring about other people again. It was just me against the world. And the world had it coming. The first synths weren't all that impressive. I'm good, but I'm not that good. But the Institute could always make more, and kept making them better each time. They still give me the creeps, but you have to get used to them if you want to do. The first synths weren't all that. You heard all sorts of rumors about the Institute, but I figured they were just a convenient boogeyman for anything bad that ever happened. They were real, all right. They didn't know anything about operating on the surface. Relied on their synths for everything. They had the resources I needed, and I had the expertise they needed. Turned into a permanent arrangement. Which suited me just fine.
I wanted to see for myself if you really existed.
We do, as you can see.
What do you want?
It's come to my attention that you've been rather disruptive of our operations lately. This must stop.
I do what people pay me to do. If that's a problem for you, I can see only one way out.
And what's that, Mr. Kellogg?
If I'm working for you, there's no more problem. From what I hear, you can afford me.
I don't think you fully understand the situation you're in.
I think I do.
Very well. B-748. Initiate. Impressive. We may have something to talk about after all.
Getting warmer. One of these has got to tell us something. We're running out of brain here. There's one that looks mostly intact. Connecting now.
Manual override initiated. Cryogenic stasis suspended.
Eggheads never like taking orders from a dirty, contaminated degenerate like me. But they needed me. And I made sure they knew it.
Vault computers are still...
I was now the Institute's main operator in the Commonwealth. If they needed something done, they came to me. It wasn't usual for anybody from the Institute to come along on a mission, so this one stood out. They didn't know then who it was we were grabbing from the vault. Of course, neither did they. Not really. I never knew why we didn't just refreeze the rest of them. But we had our orders. Guess the old man didn't want so many loose ends. Too bad he left alive the one person he shouldn't have. I'm glad I didn't have to kill the kid. I'm not saying I haven't done it, but, I never liked to. But it was better this way. Better than taking his kid and leaving him alive.
That's good. Checking through the logs. Hopefully it's all...
Just... Even then, I knew it was a mistake leaving her alive. I understood that kind of revenge. No one better. But I was cocky enough to assume I could handle some soft, pre-war vault dweller, even if she somehow got thawed out. At least I know those Institute bastards will soon get what's coming to them, too. If she could take me out, they won't be able to hide from her for long.
Find it. Pod C6, down the hall near the end.
This is the one. Here.
Open it.
Is it over?
Almost. Everything's going to be fine. Okay?
Come here.
No.
Come here, Gravy.
No. I've got him!
Let the boy go. I'm only gonna tell you once.
I'm not giving you Sean!
God damn it. Get the kid out of here and let's go. At least we still have the backup.
Cryogenic sequence reinitialized.
What's the holdup?
I'm almost finished, Kellogg. I just need to confirm. All right, we're good.
I'm sorry you had to go through that again. I found another intact memory. Whenever you're ready.
Wasn't my idea to settle down with the kid in the middle of Diamond City.
This appears to be a very recent memory, so...
I thought it was a terrible idea, actually. But it was one of the old man's pet projects, so here we were. Me and the kid, like a happy little family. I ended up kind of liking it. A reminder of what my life might have been if things had turned out differently. But there's no going back. I knew it was just temporary. It'd be back to normal business before too long. This whole setup in Diamond City was part of some elaborate plan of the old man's. Seems obvious now that we were bait for our friend from the vault. Timing couldn't have been an accident. It's not how the old man works. I wonder if he outsmarted me in the end. Another loose end tied up.
Kellogg.
It's okay. One of these days you're gonna get your head blown off just barging in here like that. The new breed of synths could easily pass as human. Some of them did. But the coursers, they weren't built to blend in. They were killing machines, pure and simple. Smarter, stronger, and faster than almost any real human. I'm just glad they were always on my side.
Raising my exposure to civilians is a priority.
Forget I said anything. So what's the big crisis this time?
New orders for you. One of our scientists has left the Institute.
Left? As in?
He's gone rogue. Name's Dr. Brian Virgil. We know he's hiding somewhere in the glowing sea. Here's his file.
Wow. Some heads are gonna roll for this. Capture and return, or just elimination?
Elimination. He was working on a highly classified program.
No kidding. One of the top bioscience boys? Damn. So, I guess you're taking the kid back with you.
Affirmative. Your only mission is to locate and eliminate Virgil.
You're taking me home to my father?
Yes. Stand next to me and hold still.
Okay.
X-688, ready to relay with Sean.
Bye, Mr. Kellogg. I hope I see you again soon.
Bye.
Teleportation. Now it all makes sense. Nobody's found the entrance to the Institute because there is no entrance. Let me pull you out of there as soon as you're ready. Okay? I don't know what kind of side effects the procedure might have had. No one's ever done this before. How do you feel?
Next time I have to watch someone's life story, I want popcorn.
Well, if you're cognizant enough to joke, I think we can safely say that you're out of critical condition. Are you ready?
There's more than one person who knows about the Institute.
I didn't know Institute scientists could defect. Where did the memory say he was? The Glowing Sea?
That's why he's there.
That must be it. He's using the radiation in the Glowing Sea like a shield. If Virgil found a way to survive there, you'll have to do the same.
Oh, I'm going in naked.
I know you're joking, but as a doctor, I feel obligated to remind you that unprotected radioactive exposure will only kill you. Dead. D-E-A-D. So be sure you find a way to get through there with your life intact. And good luck. By the way, I unplugged Mr. Valentine first. Remove the implant while you were waking up.
Using your robot powers for good. Nick.
Hope you got what you were looking for inside my head. That was right. I should have killed you when you were on ice.
You want to try for round two, huh? Let's go.
What? What are you talking about?
You sounded like Kellogg just then.
Did I? Huh. Mari said there might be some mnemonic impressions left over. Anyway, I feel fine, so let's... Or I could head back to Diamond City.
We have to head into the Glowing Sea.
Well, I'm a synth, so radiation isn't much of an issue for me. That, or you could buy up all the Rad-X and Rad-Away you can find from it.
Let's get going, Nick.
Been one heck of a ride so far.